Oh, my bad.
I forgot that overhead camera was on.
Okay, all right, okay. Going to be trying the Popeyes fried chicken sandwich since it's got such a craze right now. But we are going to do this vegan style, no meat, no soy. So to start out, you will need jackfruit. I don't know if you guys can see that can, and I don't know how many this is going to make, so we're kind of just experimenting with what sizes and everything. But now we need for our ingredients. We are going to need some onion powder, a little bit of chili powder, some smoked paprika, some poultry seasoning, ground annatto. Originally, when I looked at the Popeyes somewhat recipe, it said annatto liquid. I don't have annatto liquid. I just have annatto powder. Some garlic powder. A little bit of cayenne powder. Some turmeric. Some coriander cumin powder. Some dried white pepper, pretty much ground black, ground white pepper. Pure cane sugar again. I'm gonna make a recipe that calls for agave. I promise you, people. I don't know
why I keep coming.
It's because we're making a new recipe. So usually the first time, I try to substitute just sugars for sugars or whatever for whatever. But then later on, I'll start tweaking it. Gonna need good old sea salt. Get that umami flavor, we are going to go with some mushroom seasoning. And some green mango powder, because that too also gives a little seasoning to it too. Some Frank's Red Hot. Didn't have Louisiana, but I'm not going to go buy one since I have this full bottle of Frank's. Gonna need some mustard. It calls for dry mustard, which is already in the poultry seasoning. But from what I see, people use like a couple tablespoons. So I'm gonna use a little bit of this. We're gonna see how to actually put that in there. And some key lime juice or lemon juice, your choice. Key lime is better. We also have some plant-based milk. It doesn't matter what kind you're using. This just happens to be almond because it's what I got in the refrigerator right now, just not flavored. Of course, you're going to need some water. You're going to need your dry gridge, so you're going to need your regular flour, and you're going to need chickpea egg replacer. If you guys want to know how to make this, I'll just let me know in the comments, and I'll do a small video on just how to make the chickpea egg replacer so you don't have to use other stuff. And of course, some frying oil. I noticed in the Popeyes it said beef tallow. We would not be using that. Not be using beef tallow. But I have regular vegetable oil and a mix of grapeseed oil because I don't have enough grapeseed oil to cover it, so we're gonna mix the grapeseed and the vegetable. And with that, let's get some bowls and get started. So first things first, we need to make our buttermilk since we don't do buttermilk. So just take your plant-based milk and add your key lime juice or lemon juice. Usually it's about 1 to 1, 1 cup of milk versus 1 teaspoon, maybe tablespoon, teaspoon. But right now we're gonna do tablespoon to milk. And since I have 3 cups of milk, just about 3 cups, right? Yeah, a little over 3 cups, 3.5 cups of milk. We're just gonna pour it in. Two and three. That way it can be mixing while we're doing other stuff. Mix that all up together. You'll start seeing it looking like it's gonna curdle. See that already? Set that to the side. Next, we need to do what's called making our accent seasoning, because we're not going to really buy that. It has a lot of MSG, and I don't really want to buy it because we're not really going to use it that much, but we're going to make a substitution for that. Okay, to make the substitution, you're going to need basically 1 tablespoon of just about everything I'm going to say, except for like the mushroom seasoning and the mango powder, but I will have the measurements in the description down below once we make this and make sure it tastes good, people. I don't want to be giving y'all no recipe and it tastes like crap. So now,
1 tablespoon of coriander. These are not exact measurements. I don't really do that. I try to do it with bacon, but yeah, I'm a black chick from the south. So, coriander. I have 1 teaspoon of turmeric. The annatto powder. This calls for 1 teaspoon of this. 1 teaspoon of annatto powder. 1 tablespoon of garlic powder. One good thing about making this at home, you can have some left over. Oh no, you have some left over anyway, you can buy it at the store. But you'll know what's in it. Instead of having all that MSG, just mix it with everything else. And you can substitute for the MSG, which is usually like an umami flavor. So just use the mushroom powder, the green mango powder. That'll definitely work. Some salt. And I'm going to use all of this mix of a substitute accent seasoning. But we'll just mix it together and then use a little bit of it. And then I can have some sitting on my counter for later. So we don't have to do so much mixing. And I need some oregano. Hold on, oregano. Yeah, 1 tablespoon of oregano. Which mine is in clump little bits. So what we're going to do is just crush it up in my hand and put it in there. So that way, we don't have to use our mortar and pestle today, because I got a lot of dishes, y'all. Happy go get on me about all these dishes. That goes in there. And then our mushroom seasoning. And for this, we're only going to do 1/2. Let's just do 3/4. I really don't want to do a full teaspoon of that. Tablespoon. 3/4 of a teaspoon. I don't want to do a full teaspoon of that. It's very strong seasoning. So you don't need a whole lot. Now, the green mango powder. We're only going to do 1/2 teaspoon of it. Which, oh my gosh, is very cloudy on the top. I haven't used this one, I think, in a while. Green mango powder. There we go. Gonna mix this up pretty good here. The clumps out. Maybe I should have used my mortar and pestle. I don't want to get that out today. Okay. Yeah, make sure you get all the little clumps so you don't get like spots of just overpowering flavor of anything. without the MSG. And there we go. That's a pleasing.
Without the MSG. Now, Will said that to these eyes. We're back. So, buttermilk has been setting. We've made the annatto powder. I have opened all the cans of jackfruit and rinsed them very well. Rinsed them very well. Now, we need to cut this up like shreds of chicken. But what you have to do is cut this little part out because it's hard. And it's the, almost the core. But you also have to take these little seeds out. See that? You have to take the... You have to take these little seeds out. You'll see them. There'll be the pod, and then there'll actually be the actual seed. So make sure we do that. And let's do this right quick. Kind of tedious, but hey. Actually, it's not tedious work. It's about the same amount of work as with... regular meat, just you don't do all the work. You just go to the store and pay the more expensive price for the prepackaged stuff. You don't get to see all the stuff that they do. But, anyway. Alright, and we're going to just tear this up into little shreds as we go. There we go. This, you can keep. I've used it in other stuff. I've actually just cooked it, fried it, and ate it, which I think... I'm going to keep it so we can do something else with it.
So, there is little seed pods in there. Make sure you get those off. And I got to stop throwing them in my actual meat there. But little seed pods. Make sure you pull them out. They pretty much pop out on their own, but turn it over just to make sure. You get the others too, because they're on both sides. It's a little work, but hey, if you don't want to do the work, you can easily leave them. I'm just taking them out right now. And look at that. That looks like chicken, right, people? Like, look at that. Again, just open it up, find your seed pods, shred it like chicken.
Again, let's do this one more time. Take those out. They're pretty easy to pop out. Check both sides. I mean, you possibly could leave those in there too. Again, I have left them before. I'm just trying to do this as a straight up chicken. So
I have shredded up all of the jackfruit. I don't know if you guys can see that. It looks like chicken, right?
Chicken. These are the pieces that are left over. Like I said, you can keep them and use them for something else. If it hadn't been enough, I would have just shredded them up in the food processor and added them too. This right here doesn't hold as much flavoring as this does. So it can be a little tender, especially if it's a newer can. Like if it hasn't been in the brine in the can for a long time, it can be much harder. So I didn't even waste my time. Just made this. But y'all, let me tell y'all something. I had cut the camera to save y'all some time, right? So I stopped. And of course, I'm taking a little break. And I'm on social media. I was on Melanated People, to be exact. If y'all don't know what that is, it's a social website too. But much better. But anyway, so I was on there and I was reading a status. And just goes to show you how freaking nosy I am. So I'm reading it, and the gentleman is talking about how he got stopped by the cops. So, of course, it's a black guy, so I'm reading and making sure, like, oh, here we go again, you know. And so I'm reading it, and it says about how he had ordered some spray on Amazon, the poop spray, and how he had sprayed it in his car because he had got stopped for speeding, and how the cop walked up to the car, and he thought he had pooped on himself, so the cop ended up escorting him home. But at the end, he says that this is a status that he stole, and it's not even true for him. But y'all, I was so into that damn thing. I was reading it line for line, like, he about to get in trouble. Oh, the cop gonna do something to him because he don't want to get out the car because he done pooped on himself. Here we go, another black man being stopped. That shit was too funny at the end when I realized it was just a joke. But go to Melanated People, y'all. It is an awesome website. Awesome website. It is owned by us, so there's none of that Facebook jail or getting suspended or YouTube flagging your post or anything like that. So it is strictly us, and we let you be free. So melanatedpeople.net, people, melanatedpeople.net. It's an awesome website. I be on this shit too much. Too much. But back to doing what we need to do.
So now we need to actually get our homemade buttermilk bag. As you can see, it has separated, like, what buttermilk does. Mix it up. And there we go. Now we do need to add our Frank's Red Hot to this. And because I'm a little scary when it comes to hot stuff. Like, I can do a pinch of cayenne in my food and stuff like that, but you don't catch me eating, like, hot wings and stuff like that, because I'm a little scary. But because this is 3 cups, we're going to do 2 tablespoons. Hopefully, it won't burn me later. That ain't going to work. Let's do it this way. I'll be all day trying to do it that way. 1. Y'all pray for me. 2. I tell you, I'm scary. Let's go 2.5. 2.5. Yeah. I'm scared. It's hot. That, and then we're going to add a little turmeric in there too. Let's just go with about 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric. Get a little bit of color there and some nutrition. Help us out while we being greedy. Mix that all up together. Then we have to marinate our chicken in buttermilk. So the way we're going to do that, just going to marinate this in the buttermilk hot sauce recipe. Just pour enough until it's covered. Look like I ended up using the whole thing. I think. Should be enough. Okay, y'all. So I have put the buttermilk in there. I did add the mustard because I realized I probably need to put all liquid ingredients in here and just make a dry ingredient on the side. So I did add the mustard. I did a teaspoon of mustard, since mustard is very strong, and also the fact that poultry season has dried mustard in it already. So now I am going to add to it, though, just 1 teaspoon of the mock action. To it. That way it can all be marinating together. Now this should go in your refrigerator cover and put it in the refrigerator for at least 1 hour for marination. New York, do you let it taste? y'all see that? We are going to put this in the refrigerator and we'll be back. While the chicken is marinating for about an hour in the refrigerator, we're going to go ahead and mix our seasonings. I'm going to make a large batch of it and so I can have some later so I don't have to do this again. If I want to make this again, that's a very good idea. Like when you're making something, you have to use a lot of seasonings. If you make it, pre-make it in a little bowl or something first, a couple of sizes of it, like three times it or something, then you could just scoop out as you need it instead of having to redo this over and over again, open a lot of seasoning jars and packages and stuff. I know I get tired of them because stuff like this, man, I'd be a waste of this stuff. So I try to mix all that stuff together. So let's get started. First things first.
Let's go with the teaspoon. We will try to do teaspoons here. And maybe some halves. So, 2 teaspoons of salt. Do y'all ever just get the salt right into the thing? I don't. Especially when I'm doing it like this. 1, 2. I'm supposed to be doubling this up, right? So I need 6 eggs. Tripling this recipe. Tripling it. 5 teaspoons of smoked paprika. 5 teaspoons of smoked paprika. 2 and 5. 3 teaspoons of garlic powder. I pretty much say heaping because, you know, again, I don't do exact measurements. I'm always experimenting with something. Something about people who don't eat meat, right, and animal products. We have to learn to make things taste like, so we're experimenting people. Alchemists, scientists, all that stuff. Not saying I'm a scientist or anything, but just saying, we do a lot of experimenting. 3 teaspoons of onion powder. Onion powder. 1, 2, and 3. Another. Then we need the white pepper. It's pretty much like black pepper, it just doesn't leave the black specks to me. It's pretty much the same. And we're going to do 3 teaspoons of that. All this stuff, y'all see I got it all wrapped up. More of a powdery too instead of like a something gritty like. I'm a rubber band because I don't trust myself. Seasoning, and we're going to do about 3 teaspoons of that too. Looks like 3 is the lucky number in this. Because, again, we're experimenting with measurements because the original recipe calls for like 8 pieces of chicken. That's like chicken, right? Chicken where you're just seasoning it outside. But because my chicken is all shredded up, I am going to season it all the way through. Now we will be adding, ooh yeah, again, I'm telling you, like, this is why I probably didn't really eat Popeyes in the first place because, like I said, spicy. I don't really do spicy. But we're going to see about 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. Yeah, just 1/4. If you like spicy hot, go for it. Put the whole thing in there. Best of luck to you. Enjoy your food. But not me. So I'm going to put that over there. And then I'm also going to add some ginger. I know I didn't say this probably earlier when I was naming off the stuff, but I just thought about it. And I always like to put ginger because, again, something a little healthy even though you're eating something bad. Give myself some nutrition. So we're going to do about 1/2 teaspoon of that. And we're going to do the coriander cumin. Another one of these packages, y'all. I'm going to have to get some more jars, because I don't got another one. I'm telling you, my kitchen is just already overloaded with a bunch of seasonings and spices. So for this, let's just say we're going to do a full teaspoon of the coriander cumin. Ooh, rubber band. I already put that on there. That's 1/4 of chili powder. Well, maybe 1/2, really. For that. Add some onion. Give a little more extra chicken flavor. And with the poultry seasoning, we're probably going to do 2 heaping teaspoons. Okay, now some sugar to add to that, get that sweetness. But you know, we're all addicted to basically 2 things in this country. I know people talk about drugs, but sugar and dairy products, those are addictions, people. Like, we really can't hardly live without them. And it's like, it's hard to kick them. If you think, just try. Like, go 1 week without sugar. Go 1 week without dairy. If you are a person who eats a lot of dairy, like, I don't try not to eat too much sugar, but that's kind of like my weakness, people, sugar. So, we're going to go with 2 teaspoons of this. Sugar is in everything, even the things you think it's not in, like your fried chicken. 1 and 2. Just mix this all up here. See, that's quite a bit of seasoning, right? So, if this chicken, I think the seasoning itself is pretty good. So, if this chicken turns out to be pretty good, like, this would be awesome. I won't even have to do this part again for a while. Just make sure you get all that mixed up together. So, again, so you don't have spikes and peaks of certain flavors because you didn't mix it all together, didn't get the clumps out. Since the salt is at the bottom.
Now you don't even gotta make the seasoning up or just add all your seasonings. All you gotta
add all your seasonings. All you gotta do,
get you just pour this on there. You don't gotta add all these ingredients together or look at the recipe and find out how much of your ingredients, things like that. All you gotta do, put this in a little bottle with maybe a little shaker on top. If not, just one of these little glass jars like this. Get you a measuring spoon. But, very on Popeye's chicken seasoning without the MSG. Because that accent seasoning, I think that's why people are going crazy for the Popeye's chicken. It's the accent seasoning because that it has MSG in it, like a bunch of other, like, when I looked at it, it has few things that I don't want, so that's why I decided to make my own, because a lot of chemicals and stuff, even though I try to be less as possible doing that stuff. But very on Popeye's chicken seasoning. Set that to the side, do some cleanup, and we'll come back and start making these chicken patties.
Oh yeah, that camera is on. Okay, I'm finna get started right now. Right now. Just give me a second. I'm looking for. There it is. Okay. Alright, I'm coming.
Alright, happy people, we are back. So, while the chicken was marinating and I was draining off the marinade, I thought, how is it really gonna stick together? So, let's just do this. And again, y'all are going to have to read all the ingredients in the description box because I'm just making this up as I go. But I had started putting, I thought I need some kind of starchy something to really just make it bind together. So we're going to use tapioca starch and we're going to use some sea moss gel just because we want all those nutrients. Do you guys know this has like 102 minerals in it? And your body needs like only like 112, so it basically has all of them. But I was putting the tapioca starch. Going to do like, since this is a lot, I'm going to do like 3 teaspoons of it, and I already put 1 teaspoon in there, so we're going to go with just 2 more here. And the sea moss. This is probably like a sea moss gel. This is probably like a tablespoon to a tablespoon and a half. And we're gonna add some water. And we're just gonna measure. I guess I should measure this out, huh? So y'all know. 1/4 cup increments. So let's start with that. 1/4 cup increments. This is room temperature water. I wouldn't go with cold water because your sea moss needs to dissolve if it's gel. Let's start with that. Mix this up. sea moss gel, people, besides using it just for the nutrition, it's all, people use it to also thicken things, to make things bind together, and in place of gelatin, because gelatin, of course, has bone marrow, some animal products. So people use it to replace gelatin too. I know I do. But just a teaspoon a day will definitely keep the doctor away. Forget the apple. A teaspoon of sea moss. Or put it in your smoothies. You can put it in your drinks. It's pretty much tasteless. I would say smell-less, but definitely not a bad smell and not a bad taste. You can mix it in anything and nobody would actually know that it's there. And so we put a little slurry to be a little, just so it can be something that'll bind it together.
I be on that melanated people, y'all, so I forget that I'm even waiting on something to marinate or get cold or whatever. But look at that, you know, when you first get it. So now we are going to add our seasoning mix to this, and I would say let's just go with, I'm going to go with a tablespoon. Well, I like a lot of seasoning, y'all, so how about, let's go with about 2 tablespoons of this.
Alright, so now that we've added our seasoning mixture, I'll just mix this in together here. I don't really want to do too much of that color to turn my whole chicken red, man. So. I can smell my seasonings already. Smell them. I'm just not satisfied, so let's just do about a half of a teaspoon. Just because I can see some areas that are not quite coated. Because I kind of got lazy at the end there and just kept going. So now let's add in our sea moss, tapioca starch, slurry. Get all that goodness out of there, all the sea moss you can. Just mix all that in. Get that all mixed up. So that way you have something in there.
Make it into chatties. So let's start this. I just have a ice cream scoop. I don't even know where my large one is at. I'm just gonna do it like this. Don't want these to be too big. You won't be able to cook them all the way through.
It's gonna be a little moist because of the sea moss and the cornstarch starch slurry. When you are draining, make sure you squeeze it out very well so you get rid of most of the liquid from the marinade. Because not, your chicken is gonna be kind of watery. Like, nobody wants wet chicken. Have you ever had wet chicken? Anyway. Again, just make your patties as big as you want them. And roll them out on a parchment paper, line, cookie sheet, cutting board, whatever you have. Some plastic wrap if you have to. And just put that on there. Because we have to put this in the refrigerator, the freezer, so it can solidify. So it don't fall apart when we're trying to do the coating. Let's do another one here. Again, just adding thing as much as you like, but try not to make them too huge because you want your inside to cook before the outside starts burning. Chicken better be all burnt up. You be talking about, it's Cajun style, you know, blackened. Smells good. That's the only good thing about the season, you know? It smells so good. Kind of wet. Maybe cut back on not so much water because of the sea moss. But hey, you live and you learn. You live and you learn.
This made about 7.5, like 7 and 1 small one. We are going to put this in the freezer for about an hour, just like with marinating it for about an hour. We need it to stiffen up so when we do the dredging and stuff like that, it won't fall apart on us, and when we throw it in the fryer, it doesn't just disperse in the fryer. Let me clean my hands and we'll be back.
Okay. So while we are waiting on the chicken to firm up in the freezer, we can go ahead and start putting our breading station together. So first thing we need is, like, they usually have an egg wash, right? So guess what? I got a chickpea egg replacement. I just usually make it up in advance. Again, like I was saying, make these things in advance so it's much easier to use when you're cooking. If you guys need the recipe for this, just comment and let me know, and I'll make a quick video of how to make the chickpea egg replacer. I even write on the bottle so I don't forget, right? See that? I don't know if you can. Y'all see that? So, and I put in these little things to make it much easier for you to pour and measure. And this one is calling for, it is a, but this is only egg replacer for washes and making eggs on the stove, not like egg replacer for baked goods or things like that. Don't do that. So now, let's do this. We need about 1/3 cup of the replacer itself. Pour that in there. About 1/3 cup. Then, as any good cook, you always season every layer of your food. So, we're gonna add, not that much, not even 1/2 tablespoon, I mean, into this. Don't need a whole lot. You just want every layer to have seasoning. This already has a little seasoning in it already. So, again, adding a little of your Popeye's seasoning mix to that. And we're going to do the water and veggie broth. So about 1/3 cup of water. Pour that in there. And about 1/2 cup. Y'all, my dog run down the steps so fast that she almost be about to fall. Fall. Because she thinks she getting some food. She hear me down here talking. So, 1/2 cup of veggie broth. More seasoning and less water. The more you use veggie broth and less water, the more seasoning your food will have. So, 1 1/2 cup. And let's just mix this all together. Chickpea flour can just clump up so bad. I don't care how you try to do it. It'll be vigorous. Vigorous. Chickpea flour. I almost have to sift it every time, like I sift them when I'm making these things, but then it clumps up again. So this just really don't look like it's going to be enough to cover everything. So what we're going to do is we're going to double the recipe. We're actually going to do double everything. So instead of 1/3 cup, it'll be 2/3 cup. 2/3 cup of chickpea flour. So now we're going to add the rest of our water. Since we did 1/3 cup, we're going to do another 1/3 cup. So 2/3 cup of water. And then our other 1/2 cup of veggie broth. Just mix this vigorously. Vigorously, y'all. Because chickpea flour ain't no joke. You don't want those little balls in your food.
I have stirred it as long as I'm possibly going to stir it. It still has some clumps in it, but it'll be okay. So we're going to set that to the side. And we're going to start mixing our flour for it, our dredge. Move that. So now I have, just about 3 cups, a little under 3 cups of all-purpose flour. Just regular all-purpose flour. And then I have 1 cup of chickpea flour. And again, this chickpea flour, y'all, I'm telling you, let me just do this right quick. A cup of chickpea flour. And then I'm going to add a little more of the annatto just for the color, because everybody knows that Popeye's chicken coating has like a darker color, almost like a red tint to it, underlay. So, we're just going to do a little sprinkles of that. We ain't even going to measure that. Just a little sprinkles. Just give it a little color. And we're back to our seasoning mix again. And this is why you keep on making, you make it in a big container. Because you're going to have to keep adding and keep adding. And because I want my skin parts to be very seasoned. Oh man, the chicken seasoning. The chicken skin part, so I want the breading to be very seasoned. So we're going to do about 1, 2, 3. And 4. Like this. And just stir it up, mix it all up real good there. Maybe just a little bit of that to that. A little bit more, because my color don't seem that dark. Get that mixed up real well. Make a mess while you're in. Now, if you ain't making a mess while you're cooking, it probably won't be that good.
Alright. It has been 1 hour since we put the chicken in the freezer. So, it is now
stiffened. Can you guys see that? So now we can start our dredging process. And let's just do this. Mix that up. It's been sitting for a second. Letting it marinate in its own seasoning. And what we'll do is take one of these. Y'all see that? Chicken patty. Put in a little flour first. And to our wash. Then we do back into the flour. Because I like a lot of crust, we're gonna go back into the wash again. Okay. And one more time into the breading mix.
Flour mix. One more time into the flour mix. Make sure you get everything coated. Once we're all coated, then you just want to set it to the side. This is just parchment paper and a cookie sheet, wire wrap, while you finish doing the rest.
For all intents and purposes, if you have a lot of them, you may want to only bring out like a few of them at a time to do this so they don't all start melting on you. Because remember, I live in hot weather, so even though the air conditioning is running full blast, things will still melt. Shake some of that flour off.
Like that. Like we're gonna bread these about three times, so just to get a nice thick coating on there, nice thick breading, flouring, crust. Tap it off. Run it again. It's messy. Yeah, you want to let these sit to the side so actually the liquid can absorb, the flour can absorb the liquid. So your breading just don't fall off. But actually the flour will absorb the liquid and it makes it more cohesive.
Alright, so cleanup is all done. We have set up our cooking station. While I was doing cleanup and setting up the cooking station, I did put them back in the freezer so just so they wouldn't melt all the way. But I did allow them to sit out for at least 1 minute or two. So just like I said, the liquid can be absorbed by, the flour can absorb the liquid. If you look at that, you can see like where it started doing it. Once I started seeing that, I just kind of put them in the freezer while I cleaned up and set up this station. So now let's see our oil. Our oil is up to temp. It should be well over 375 now. Actually, we are at 384. So we are ready to put these in. Let's see how this goes. I'm just going to use a spatula because I don't want it to drip on me. Just slap that in there like that. And I'll do two at a time so my temperature doesn't go down too much. And it cooks pretty fast. And I'll bring this temp up a little, just a little bit. You guys see that frying? I wasn't even studying no chicken, but after I heard Popeye's chicken, Popeye's chicken, Popeye's chicken like 1,000 times. Social media, at home, at work, standing in the grocery store. Popeye's chicken. So subconsciously, now I wanted some chicken. Alright, so this guy is floating now. Has a good color on it. That.
table. There's a piece of veggie chicken. Veggie chicken. Got to go on business for myself.
Okay, so we have assembled our chicken sandwich. I don't know if you guys can see that. That looks awesome. Now, Popeyes just has a brioche bun, but there's no really brioche bun I could find that didn't have any dairy products in it. So this is a potato bun with no dairy products. Bought it from Walmart. I think it's the Oral Wheat brand. They also have a like Cajun sauce, so I just took some veggie mayo and my own Cajun mix. If you need a recipe for that, just comment that down below and I'll put up a quick recipe of how to make that. Make the Cajun seasoning so you can mix it with the mayo and some pickles. So, looks good to me. Let's test this boy out and see.
Thank you, God, for this food. Amen.
Amen. Little white chicken up in there. It really is, like, I can do this. We don't need to sit in Popeye's line for no 3 or 4 hours for them to tell us they ain't got no more chicken sandwiches.
We can make you one for 3 or 4 hours.
Yeah, this is pretty good. So, y'all, make your own sandwiches so you'll know what's actually in them. All the products they put in some of this stuff is just ridiculous. But until next time,
stay happy.
All right, hold on, now we're done.
When I tell y'all this sandwich is good, it's amazing. It's really amazing. Like, look at that. I'm almost done already. This sandwich is so good. I'm glad I cooked more than one, because I don't know if I'm going to be able to sleep through the night without having to get up and come and get another one of these sandwiches. Y'all need to make this.